Hello, everyone. Paolo Donlibledo from CDN Magazine. We're here at the Cisco Partner Summit in Boston with the president of Cisco Canada, Nitin Kuwali. Nitin, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
Nitin, you're on the job. What would be some of your highlights and some of the things that you're still trying to work on?
Yeah, well, you know, I've been at the job for about a year, and I tell you, it's been a pretty eventful and exciting year. Obviously, we've had some economic roller coasters. We've acquired some companies, gotten into new markets, so I can tell you it's been quite exciting. Canada as a whole for Cisco has been doing extremely well. Our business continues to grow. We continue to focus on the markets that we want to. And our partners, I believe, are starting to understand some of the strategic shifts that we're making. And they're very simple. For example, we're trying to look at the business through three lenses. You know, geographies, verticals, products and solutions. We'll take that to architecture now this scenario. And what we're trying to do is to, from a partner perspective, come up with meaningful areas of focus as you intersect between products, verticals, and geographies. What's really important for their business plan, and what's important for our business plan, and where we intersect, come up with really meaningful scenarios. And I think that allows us to drive a tighter relationship with partners and drive better success with our customers. The other thing we're focusing on is to really improve the efficiency and effectiveness of how we work with our partners. To really look at it from a customer in perspective, so the customer sees one entity driving a solution, whether it's done by individuals in our partners or ourselves. And we're going to use our collaboration tools as much as possible to drive that employee productivity on the partner side and our side, and obviously through the partner conference you've seen all sorts of examples on that. And so we're very keen to start to roll that out in a very significant way. So much still needs to be done, but great progress to the first year. I'm extremely pleased where the business is. Obviously, having Donna Whitman join us on the channel side is a great coup for us. I'm delighted she's off to a flying start, and I know it's going to have a tremendous impact on our business.
I want to ask you about unified computing system. Sort of a very interesting play, pretty major announcement without a doubt. But it led to a little bit of friction with one of your top integration partners, HP. But also on the flip side, it led to some pretty fantastic partnerships in the channel with Compugen, who has an industry pioneer in Harry Zarek, and one of the more visionary channel partners out there in Longview. How did you balance out those kinds of challenges?
Well, you know, this is a very exciting area for us. And I think what we have to really understand is where we're going. And it's not in the traditional space of a better, faster server. And so that's a lot of a commodity price play. What we're doing is we're putting together three platforms, right? The network platform, the virtualization platform, and the compute platform. And it's in a network-centric fashion. So when you look at Harry and his company and Don and his company, really they understand the network-centric components of the data center. So having industry leaders like that on board is obviously very gratifying. And I think this approach is also going to allow us to have other partners come into this space. Getting back to your question on specific to Hewlett Packard, obviously we've had a very long-standing relationship with Hewlett Packard, and I personally know the management team there very well. And I think what Cisco getting into this market provides customers with more choice. Hewlett Packard doesn't necessarily share our network-centric vision of the data center, but yet we have a lot of joint customers. So I think when it comes to this particular area, We'll look to other partners to drive this with customers. But where it makes sense for our customers and our business, we'll continue to work with HP.
Okay. Video is very, very important to your business going forward. How are Canadians embracing video in the marketplace?
You know, I think video truly inside the enterprise is a game changer. And I talk to customers and partners about this all the time. And what we've done ourselves inside of Cisco is use video to the nth degree, and it's driven tremendous productivity. You've heard through this conference all the statistics, so I won't repeat them in terms of how much time and money we've saved by using telepresence. But it's not just telepresence. It's the ability to communicate in a different way. So video in itself is a great technology, but the ability to understand what video can do from a business process change and how you can impact that, I think is huge. And I think Canadian businesses are starting to really turn into that, I mean, tune into that in a significant way. And I believe this is a game changer, and over the next two or three years, enterprises, large and small, are going to embrace video much more dramatically than they are today. Just look at our acquisition of Flip.
Pure Digital.
Yeah, Pure Digital, right? And the Flip cameras. You know, people think of that as a consumer plan. Yep. Sure enough, lots of people use that from a home perspective. Yep. But now you think about it, what you can do in terms of capturing a video mm-hmm. and quickly and seamlessly without any technical help, start distributing that across your enterprise. You know, we use it to video blog. If I've just finished a meeting and I want to send it out to my mm-hmm. staff, I can take a quick video. I can provide much more robust communications right. in terms of the visual stuff. So it's pretty exciting, and I think that we're just on the cusp of yeah. this thing going in a very accelerated fashion in enterprises.
You mentioned telepresence. I want to quickly yeah. touch on that. A lot of the partners here at the Partner Summit were really encouraged that it's going down market. They're yep. finally saying, now we have a really chance to, you know, sell this stuff right. profitably. But how are you going to balance that with, you know, your objectives of going into the home with telepresence and eventually even at retail?
Sure. Well, you know, at the end of the day, that's the vision, right? Mm-hmm. Telepresence will become ubiquitous, right. not only in the business world, but also in the home world, and it's in a sense interconnect. Mm-hmm. And business-to-business video and home-to-home telepresence mm-hmm. is going to happen. If you think about it, depending upon how you use it, you still need somebody to provide the service, the connectivity,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
Also, as you look at driving specific solutions, you're still going to need partners. And I think from a go-to-market perspective, it's still a complete partner play for us. I think this is a new area. I think the market will shake out. Mm-hmm. And even if you look at traditional models, let's look at TV, for example,
okay.
right? At the end, you can either buy mm-hmm. your set-top box, you can lease a set-top box mm-hmm. or have it wrapped up in a service. And that might be a little analogy to think about
okay.
when you go to telepresence in the home.
Last question. I heard that you had a face-to-face meeting with David Suzuki.
Oh, yeah, it was a great experience.
Yeah. And I know all the vendors out there want to be the most green, aspire to be the most green IT vendor out there. But what's Cisco's green plan
sure.
for Canada? And how are you going to encourage your partners to deliver more green IT solutions? And I wondered if David gave you any advice on that.
Yeah, well, you know, we had a wonderful discussion. He's a fascinating man.
Absolutely.
And a great Canadian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think from a green perspective, Cisco globally has a very broad green strategy. We have a green council. We're part of that as Canada. We're part of the Clinton Global Initiative. I mean, there's a whole litany of green activities that we're doing. Canada, of course, we're very keen on that. Obviously, you followed our Million Acts of Green campaign, captured the heart and souls of Canadians. We're very proud of that program. And I think it put us on the map in terms of our environmental activities. You know, the great part about, you know, driving green and also looking at our solution sets, you know, they enable green in a very significant way, whether it's collaboration, virtualization, the amount of energy our equipment will use on the virtualization side. I talked a lot about how we could resource scale and avoid travel and use our collaboration techniques to drive a green solution set. The work we're doing with connected real estate and in connected cities, all of that stuff ties into our green program. So, you know, at a broad level, we want to be environmentally friendly. We want to make sure that we're not only green, but we're leading in Canada in terms of green, but also enabling our customers and partners to drive green solution sets just by using our technology and changing those business processes, automatically driving a green agenda within their corporations. And so we're very excited and proud about our green efforts in Canada.
Okay, great. Well, there you have it. Some very interesting comments from Nitin Kowali, the president of Cisco Canada. Nitin, thank you very much. I wish you all the best.
Pablo, thank you very much.
Yeah. Paul Dellingbeto for CDN here in Boston. Thank you.